Good evening, my countrymen. For the nth time, I have lost the counting. Who I meet my cabinet members who are critical in the fight against COVID. Alam mo, huwag na lang tayo magsisihan kasi nandyan na rin yan. There were rules imposed hoping that at least not everybody but a majority will honor at least rules and regulations promulgated by government for your own good, para sa inyo lang at para sa lahat. Eh, ngayon, yung iba hindi talaga sumunod, yung nakalabas. So, mayroon na tayo ngayong 30,682 cases dito sa aking kopya. Ang fresh, may bago lang, it's 467. Yung late comers, ibig sabihin bago lang, is 163. Cases reported total is 630. Ang recoveries, which is a good number to me, is 8,143. Pero ang namatay, humahabol rin, it's 1,177. Medyo naghabulan lang ang patay pati ang recovery. Do maganda ang recovery natin, mga kababayan ko. Ang Cebu ngayon ang may problema. May problema sila. Alam mo kasi pag may problema, tapon na na yan eh. If you solve the problem locally amongst the officials there, there's bound to be a derailment in the programs of government because they would start to blame each other. And nobody would try to introduce novel ideas or even to implement one that is already, a measure that is already of proven efficacy kasi nagsisisihan na. So, kayong mga taga Cebu, it's not that I do not trust your capability, but rather I said it's the penchant to go into a sort of a yung sisihan nga tapos nobody would answer for anything. So mga kaigsunan ako sa Cebu, both sa mga siyudad o probinsya, akong ipadala si General Simato. General Simato is the secretary of SADR. Sa DNR rather. I'm sorry. Sa DNR, sabi ko, kung maiwanan mo yung opisina mo sandali, total ikaw yung inuutosan noon ni GMA, President Arroyo, pati ako. Kayong lahat naman eh. And dito sa Manila, the head body of that is the IATF. Then, itong kayong office ni Secretary Simato would be an adjunct to that body. So, he will exercise all the powers of that body upon notifying General Lorenzana, who heads the agency. All he has to do, not for permission, but just to advise Manila here that these things are being done, these things are not yet done, and these things must be done. So I cannot wait for the transition of communication of asking for approval. Then that is the bane of bureaucracy. Sa totoo lang. Yan ang tigabigay sa atin ng how do you term it? A fractured communication even among the sometimes yung isang sulat hindi pinapansin. Kaya sabi ko kay General Simato, just exercise the powers of the task force. Anyway, you are an adjunct to an office there. I will just write a executive order. Pukul nama si Guanbong. Medyal dia. To follow. And he might fly anytime. You can use the Air Force or any plane that is available, government-owned. Baski anong aeroplano dyan, go there and fly. I suggest that you sa Air Force kasi maraming air assets. At makarating ka kaaluan, if you want to stay there or you might want to fly back. But I must have the picture of how grave the situation is, or the situations are, and malaman ko na may bawaan ako nga naanay taong nagpalihok anang sa Cebu. Kaysa Cebu na ay dagang pasangil, na ay pasangil nga tao, na ay dili gusto, na ay silusay muna. So that's the problem there. Pero wala ko'y tunong nga tao. I'm just sad that Cebu has to undergo that kind of painful situation now. But nonetheless, kaya natin yan. And I'm sure si Mato, he cannot solve the problem on his own. He has just to make recommendations and let us know what we should be doing. And that is very important. It's part really of the intelligence work of any organization to know what is ahead and behind and on the side so that you'd know how to prepare and go and fight the enemy. COVID. So that's it.